The picturesque harbor of Nassau, capital of New Providence, one of the Bahama Islands, is the center of the sponge industry. The fishing boats are often away for weeks at a time, reaping the underwater harvest from the sponging grounds. Yet preparations for the long trips are not very evident on the quayside, and while some food is taken, a good deal can be obtained on the sponging grounds. The actual sponge fishing is done from a small boat. Searching the seabed through a glass-bottomed bucket, the fisherman hooks up the sponges with a long pole. He is the real sponger. Some of the largest sponges in the world come from the Bahamas. This must be the sort father swallows on Saturday night. By the way, did you know that sponges are animals? Very low class, of course, but animals nevertheless. Strange to say, the first job on landing the catch is washing the sponges before laying them in the sun to dry. All sorts, sizes and shapes make up this harvest of the seabed. Some are too large to use, so they are cut into smaller and more suitable sizes. Dusky maidens trim the sponges, and that's the last operation before baling them for shipment to the world's baths. Father says a sponge in the throat's worth two in the bath.